The government is dragging their feet on my request for information about the screening of border crossers. Today, I'm going to tell you what I was asking them for and why I don't think I will know this information for at least another 10 months. Now, normally, I don't like to give you a sneak peek of any of my stories before I'm ready to tell you all about them. I don't like to give away an investigation while I'm still busy working on it. Sometimes I do have to roll out the information to you in a series of stories because there's just so much of it. But while we're in the process of getting information back from the government, I really try my best to keep a lid on everything. I don't want the government spin doctors to have a heads up, to get their excuses already cooked up for the wrongdoing that we inevitably uncover. But this time it's just so egregious that I'm going to break my own rule and tell you about something that I'm working on before I have all the information to share with you. The reason for this is because I'm not sure that I will ever get the information, or if I do get it, I won't get it in time before the next election, and I think you deserve that information long before then. So here it goes. In October of 2017, it came to light that RCMP officers were doing their jobs and keeping Canadians safe. They were screening illegal migrants flooding across the Quebec border for extremism. The RCMP were using what they called an interview guide to do a primary risk assessment on the people illegally coming across the border. I don't see the problem here. Now, I'll tell you some of the questions that were being asked, and then you can decide for yourself. Canada is a very liberal country that believes in freedom of religious practice and equality between men and women. What is your opinion on the subject? How would you feel if your boss was a woman? How would you feel about women who do not wear the hijab? How many times a day do you pray? What is your opinion of the Taliban and the Islamic State? I do sort of kind of want to know what illegal migrants feel about ISIS, don't you? As a woman, I want to know how they might feel about me walking around with my hair uncovered. Do they think it's okay to stone me? But SJWs and immigration lawyers were outraged. Same with Public Safety Minister Ralph Goodale, whose spokesperson said the department was deeply concerned about the questionnaire. And then they contacted the RCMP, calling some of the questions inappropriate and inconsistent with government policy, keeping people safe, inconsistent with liberal policy. Now, at the end of November 2017, the RCMP announced it would expunge any data on religious and cultural practices collected from Muslim refugee claimants coming across the U.S. border at that informal border crossing at Wroxham Road. The questionnaire was being redacted partly because it was deemed to be quote-unquote offensive. Now, you've heard the questions now for yourself. You tell me, was that offensive? Now, we wanted to see the data. Now, we didn't want to know anybody's names, and we went looking for the questionnaire responses. In November of 2017, we filed an access to information request with the RCMP. This is what we asked them for. It's pretty clear. Please provide copies of all of the survey responses collected from those crossing the border with personal information redacted as reported here. And then we linked back to a mainstream media report on the subject. Then we sent a second access to information request about 2 weeks later. We asked the government to provide copies of all documents, including emails, text or instant messages, memos, media lines, briefing notes, backgrounders, etc., regarding the use and creation and the pullback of the RCMP questionnaire for asylum seekers crossing the border as reported here. And then, of course, again, we linked to a mainstream media report on the matter. So, to be clear, we wanted the survey responses themselves because we wanted to see what the government is fully aware that migrants are saying with regard to equality and human rights and religious freedom. But we also wanted to see the government's planning and their frightened eventual pullback on the questionnaire. We wanted it all. So we waited and we waited and we waited. January 10th, 2019, we get a response to our requests. So to be clear, we waited all of 2018 and all of December 2017 to bring us to nearly 14 months wait time. But we don't actually get the documents. Oh no. Look at this line here. The RCMP bureaucrat says to us, please let me know if you still require the files. What? Of course we do. That's why we asked for them in the first place. So of course we responded within the allotted time of 1 week. And now, and only now, some 14 months later, the RCMP is finally getting around to figuring out exactly what we wanted from them, even though we could not possibly have been more clear the first time around. The response to us again. Please note that the RCMP have many questionnaires that are relevant to your request. Perfect, I want them all. They have already been redacted, vetted by the RCMP's Divisional Personnel Protecting Personal Information, etc. If the previously redacted questionnaires would be acceptable to you, this will speed up the process and we will be able to process your request faster. ATIP personnel would apply the same redaction procedures if we received unvetted documents from the RCMP regional office. Please let me know if a list of all redacted files would be sufficient. Thank you. So the RCMP have already redacted the personal information, and because of that, they're going to process our request faster. That's the request that we first made some 14 months ago. They don't even have to redact the information before they give it to us because it's already been redacted, apparently. So just hand it over to us. If this information wasn't bad and damning and a complete and total indictment of the Liberal government and their immigration policy, you know I'd already have it in my hands. But I suspect this is probably going to take, when's the next election again? 10 months from now to get our hands on all of this information. I think these bureaucrats are kicking the ball down the road so that we aren't able to tell the Canadian public how the illegal border crossers really feel about us and Canadian values in time for it to become a campaign issue in the next election. For the Rebel.media, I'm Sheila Gunry. The Liberal government has already threatened to censor networks like us in advance of the next election. So for you to stay on top of everything we say and do, one of the best ways to do that is to get the Rebel Media mobile app. It's available on the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store. Download it, give it a whirl, and fight Liberal censorship wherever you go.